Castries Southeast MP Guy Joseph says he thought the government would have learnt some lessons from the ravages of Hurricane Tomas and the damage done particularly in the Bexar area. However, Mr. Joseph says to date, the level of work done to mitigate flooding in that area leaves a lot to be desired. The Castries Southeast MP revealed that since the Labour government assumed office, he has submitted a number of projects aimed at improving the situation in his constituency, but they have not been implemented.
As I indicated some time ago, the level of desilting done by this present administration leaves a lot to be desired. I think the money is spent, but we do not have the value for the money spent in the constituency. And you'd recall when I said some time ago that the silt was just, some of it was just moved from the river. Some of it was just pushed on the side and left in the riverbed itself. Others were just placed on the banks. And as soon as it rained, everything went back into the river. If you go and see the level at which the silt has built up in the river, you would recognize why every time there's a little rain that we get flooding in the area.
Mr. Joseph also spoke of the plight facing Mark residents. They've been complaining of the problems they encounter in getting to work and school every time the river banks overflow. Mr. Joseph says while he was in government, he had constructed a bridge, but that bridge was damaged by Hurricane Tomas. According to the Castries Southeast MP and former Minister of Communications and Works, one of the first projects he had submitted to government was for the reconstruction of the bridge. But as far as he is concerned, the submission has been placed on the back burner.
Among the first projects I submitted to the government under the Community Development Project funded by the Taiwanese, this repair to that bridge was part of that project. I must say that I'm very disappointed with the government, and I did indicate in Parliament to the Prime Minister that I realized that there was rollover money from the constituency development project, but not a single project was implemented in Castries Southeast, at least on those recommended by myself as the parliamentary representative. This is a clear sign of discrimination by the government. And these are people, their children who live there. If there's an emergency and it's raining, nobody can get out of the area.
Bexar, which is part of the constituency that Mr. Joseph represents in Parliament, is one of the more flood-prone areas of the country. It was one of the worst affected communities during the passage of Hurricane Tomas in 2010. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.